Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love Starter. In this video, you'll learn how to set up Google Analytics 4, GA4, including e-commerce tracking on your Shopify store. The way you implement Google Analytics on your store will depend on the version of Shopify you're using. If you're using Shopify Plus, then you can add Google Analytics to every page, including your checkout pages. If you're not using Shopify Plus, then you can add Google Analytics to your store's pages and order confirmation page. However, you won't be able to add the GA4 code to the checkout pages. We'll talk about this more as we walk through the steps. Okay, let's head to Shopify to get started. Okay, so I'm in my demo Shopify store. Let's start by adding the Google Analytics tracking code to all of the pages on our store. This will mean we can understand the products people are viewing and people viewing the shopping cart. To do this, we're going to add the tracking code to our theme. So let's select Online Store. Then we select Actions and choose Edit Code from the dropdown. We're looking for the file called theme.liquid. Let's select this file. Now we need to get the Google Analytics tracking code, so let's head to Google Analytics. We can see we're in the admin area of Google Analytics, and since there are only two columns, this tells us we're looking at a GA4 property. I've already created my GA4 property, but if you're just getting started, then you can find a link to another one of my videos where I cover setting up GA4 in the description below this video. Now we need to select data streams. And then select the data stream we want to use for our Shopify store. Let's look for tagging instructions. And select Global Site Tag. This gives us the dedicated gtag.js tracking code we can use to send data to our GA4 property. So let's copy this. I'm going to show you how to set up GA4 on a standard Shopify store. Since we can't track the checkout pages, we're going to configure Google Analytics so that we don't see those pages reported as referrals. If you're using Shopify Plus, then you can skip the step I'm about to show you. To prevent our checkout pages showing up as referrals in GA4, we need to scroll to the bottom of our data stream and select More Tagging Settings. Now we need to choose List Unwanted Referrals. And we need to add Shopify to the list of domains we want to exclude. Let's add a condition. And let's choose Referral Domain Includes. And then let's enter myshopify.com. This will mean when people check out and then view the confirmation page, we won't see the checkout pages show up as self-referrals in our reports. This is important to do because it means we can see the correct marketing channels that are driving sales on our website. Now let's head back to Shopify. Okay, we need to paste the gtag.js tracking code inside the head tags of the theme.liquid file. And then we need to click Save. If you're using Shopify Plus, then you should also add the gtag.js tracking code to your checkout.liquid page, as this will let you track each of the checkout steps through to the confirmation page. If you're not using Shopify Plus, then you won't be able to report on these pages in GA4. So I recommend also implementing Universal Analytics, which is the previous version of Google Analytics on your store. By having GA4 and Universal Analytics on your Shopify store, you'll be able to take advantage of both versions. And importantly, you'll be able to see the checkout steps in Universal Analytics. Now we need to add some additional tracking code to the final confirmation page people see after they've made a purchase. We need to do this to track transactions into GA4. To do this, we select Settings and then Checkout. Then we scroll down to Order Processing and look for the option to add additional scripts. This lets us add extra code that is added to the confirmation page. I'm going to paste in a modified tracking code that includes the purchase event for GA4. This will send the transaction details to GA4, including the total value of the purchase and the items. The code includes liquid markup that will automatically include the Shopify transaction details. We can see it will automatically include the order number, price, currency, tax, shipping, and item details. I've included a link to get the code I've used in the description below this video. I recommend taking the time to review and test this code to make sure it works correctly for your store. You could also modify the code further to include additional details and logic using the liquid markup provided by Shopify. And if you're using Shopify Plus, then you could modify this code, since you would have added it to the checkout.liquid file. Now let's save the changes. Okay, now let's test out the code on my demo Shopify store. Let's head to the store. I've already loaded Tag Assistant, so we can preview the events being sent to GA4. So let's view my demo product. And add the item to the cart. We can now select the Tag Assistant tab. And we can see the pages I viewed have been sent to Google Analytics. Okay, let's head back to the store. And let's view the cart. Let's select Checkout. Enter some contact details. And continue to shipping. I'm going to leave the default selection and I'm going to continue to payment. Since this is a demo store, I can enter fake payment details. And click Pay Now. We're now on the confirmation page. The transaction has been completed. So let's select the Tag Assistant tab again. We can see the confirmation page has been sent to GA4. And we can see there is a purchase event. Let's select the purchase event. We can see the transaction details have been sent to GA4. Now let's head to GA4 to check that the purchase event has come through. Let's head to the debug view. And we can see the purchase event has come through. We can select this event. And we can see details for the transaction and the product we purchased. So that's how you can set up GA4 on your Shopify store and how you can track transactions into your GA4 reports. And remember, we've looked at using the gtag.js tracking code because it's the easiest way to get GA4 up and running on Shopify. However, you could apply a similar technique to implement GA4 using Google Tag Manager on your store. Are you going to use GA4 on your Shopify store? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.